Hi, Isha this side from EQ Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Rahul Mishra with us from Braze. A very warm welcome to you, sir, on EQ.
Thanks, thank you.
Sir, can you just let us know on about Braze, like how it came into the solar industry and what's your concept?
So Braze Power Infra is essentially a leading solar developer and a turnkey EPC solution provider. The company has been in existence since 2011, and considering the current years of capacity addition we are doing, we'll be about close to 900 megawatts of commissioned projects. Over the years, from a turnkey EPC solution provider, we've become more of a developer now, and we've been developing assets over the last 4 years, and working with leading companies and investors in the country.
So if we talk about the technology, how Braze differ from others?
See, from a technology perspective, pretty much we've been following what most of the guys are doing. But, as and when we are amongst the leaders in terms of innovating and adopting to the new technologies coming in. For example, in the current projects that we are looking at robotic cleaning. We are looking at waterless cleaning of modules now. And some of the projects now we are looking at, the latest modules which are coming. These are some of the minor things that we've been doing, on most of the projects we are working on.
If we talk about the financial year 2018 and 2019, so how much you have installed and supplied till now, and what's the future plans for 2020?
So 18-19, we actually also diversified in international markets. We commissioned a 50 megawatt project in Vietnam. And in India, we've done about another 100 megawatts. So, from last year and this year put together, we are going to be around close to 300 megawatts of projects, either under construction or commission.
So, what's your expectation with the government policies, like how it's going about at present?
See, on the central government side, there's a lot of initiatives and posts that the government is taking. However, it lacks at the state level. And that's where both center and state have to come together in terms of supporting solar and solar installation. At the same time, the payments have to happen on time for the industry to really survive. In the recent times, most of the states, there have been some trouble in terms of delay in payments, in terms of some knee-jerk reactions to re-looking at the PPAs. Now, a lot of these have to be taken care of by the central government and the state governments together.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being
here. Thank you. Thanks for speaking to me. Thanks.